Peggy 16.
Well, what does a player get up to when he's running round in the game all day long? He fights a lot, of course, to give emphasis to his words, to get someone to do what he wants. For example, if the tavern has a bouncer, I want to get in there now. Then you can either fight or talk your way through. And, well, you don't have to fight all the time in our game, but it is a central element. You get better at it and are able to improve your respective skills by fighting. We had several different sets of weapons in Risen 1, axes, staves, and swords. However, they were more or less the same in the way they had to be used. Therefore, we decided to have fewer kinds of weapons in Risen 2, but more possibilities for using a specific weapon within a fight.
Wir wollten wesentlich mehr in die Fechtrichtung gehen als bei Risen 1, wo es, oder bei den klassischen Hack-and-Slay-Dingern, wo man einfach die ganze Zeit draufhaut und dann, jetzt habe ich ihn getroffen. Und es geht darum, im Prinzip so ein Fechtgefühl zu entwickeln. Und das sollte dieser Prototyp dann auch zeigen. Es ermöglicht mir im Prinzip einfach ja, Situationen darzustellen, die in einem alten Errol Flynn ja, Piraten-Movie einfach auch passieren. Man hüpft mal über die Klinge drüber, man bückt sich mal drunter weg, mal kriegt man einen Faustschlag ins Gesicht. Das ist einfach so ein bisschen dieses auch nicht ganz faire rüberzubringen. Das war einer der Hauptzielpunkte, die wir uns gesetzt haben.
In
order to emphasize the pirate thing a bit more, we thought about how we could make the fights even more pirate-specific. What's the essence of a pirate fight? And that's where we got all the ideas about blows, punches that one can throw in a fight, and kicks, or pushing the opponent away and so forth. We wanted the fights in Risen 2 to come across like real pirate fencing duels.
A dirty trick
would be to set a parrot onto someone, distracting him so that I can hit him or do other things to him. And if I've learned to use the musket, I could try to shoot him in the meantime. We try to offer a certain variety of skills and abilities.
Skills and Fähigkeiten anzubieten. Wir sind in unseren Spielen immer bemüht darum, dass
we always try to split the game into three parts, but without having a grand plan, so it's more intuitive. There are parts where you have to fight, and there's no avoiding that. There are parts where there's a lot of talking and listening and reading. And then there are other parts where you can collect numerous things for hours and hours. And we try to interlink these parts so there's something for everyone, and the player can hopefully focus on what he enjoys most.
Das zu nutzen am ehesten, was ihm am meisten Spaß macht.
Es ist so, dass man
time and again, you're forced to resolve situations by fighting. However, you don't have to solve all situations through fighting, especially in settlements, towns and villages and so on. You really don't have to fight. However, at the latest, when you're cutting your way through the jungle and a jaguar leaps at you, it's time to draw your sword or use your rifle or whatever.
Oder das Gewehr, was auch immer.
What are the bandits doing? They do whatever they want. What's the Inquisition doing? Marching, just doing their thing.
Meaning there's a story you can get into, and here you can experience it in different ways. But at some point, everything comes to a head and you reach the end.